Let's get into our hot topics, shall we, for this morning. And first up, Liberal MP and new mum, Kelly O'Dwyer, has been advised to express more breast milk for her five-month-old baby so her breastfeeding schedule doesn't cause her to miss votes in Parliament. This came from the government's chief whip. Ms O'Dwyer was reportedly enraged by the suggestion, as rules give breastfeeding mums a proxy vote, meaning they don't actually need to be in the chamber to have their vote counted. Jess, what do you make of this scenario?
I think it is outrageous that the chief whip thinks it's appropriate to talk to a new mother in that way. I think the whole issue of breastfeeding is very... It's a very fraught topic for a lot of new mums. So to give a new mother advice on how she should or shouldn't feed her baby isn't smart anyway. And he should have known the rules, because... And also, I can't see why she couldn't breastfeed in the chamber if need be. She can watch the proceedings that are happening on a screen and still breastfeed her baby. It really angers me, because I think we need to treat working mums much better. We need to make the workplace a lot friendlier for them when they come back.
But, Jessica, if you took that to its furthest conclusion, if you were a new mother, you're suggesting that you should bring the baby in and feed it on the panel?
Well, but I suppose... but Yeah, well, I might. Or I might, like, duck around there and feed. Because when I think about our parliamentarians, I want them to be trailblazers, and I want them to make changes in the way we think about society and the way we treat people. And I think if we can't do that in Parliament, then what sort of message are we sending to the wider community about supporting new mums getting back into the workplace?
Well, I don't think you can take a baby into the chamber.
Well, why not, though?
Because it is the Parliament and that's not where babies belong.
Well, but if the baby's hungry and screaming... The Victorian MP did it, I think, Kirsty Segal, a few years ago,
and it caused
a big stir. And I think from memory, I think the Speaker actually ejected her, and it was caused a huge uproar. And then she was after that. Her and other mums, of course, were allowed.
Anyway,
to
Sarah, that solves your problem. You can bring the baby.
What is that age of that child?
Well,
her child?
Olivia was born in May, so. Yeah.
Is it like, look, I don't have an issue. I'm so liberal on that. Like, the fact that people are shocked by breastfeeding floors me. It's like, whatever. It's just so normal. But, like, is it time for her to be back at work? Like, is it...
No, but I think that's the thing. You've got to be careful about that too, because...
No, I know that, but, like, isn't there maybe a time that you should... And everybody wants to get right back...
I don't think the issue is that people are outraged that she's breastfeeding, because I think it's a very normal thing to do. But I think the criticism has been, you're there to do a job. If you can't do your job to the full extent, and look, I feel a bit sorry for this chief whip, because, you know, he said, "Oh, can't you just express more breast milk?" And he didn't speak to her in a way that said you shouldn't breastfeed your baby. Like he didn't know, and he was quickly.
Well, I was wondering, he should have known.
Quickly corrected.
It's 7 years that ruling has been in place, and I think, getting back to your point, Alex, Kelly O'Dwyer has spoken this morning, and she said that women can be mothers and they can be members of Parliament and they can perform both roles together, and. The difficulty is with a lot of new mums trying to get back to work, they still want to breastfeed their babies. Mm. You still want to have that intimacy and connection, because with a lot of mums, there's that guilt attached. Mm. And I think we need to support women in that regard.
I'm not sitting on the fence on it at all, and I'm not judging, but is it maybe just, like, I know you can do everything. Yes, you can have a baby, you can go to work, you can have, but were you doing it absolutely properly? Is it time? Do you want to wait a little bit longer? Like, I'm going back to when my mum was, when we were kids, she waited till my youngest brother was a certain age and then she went back to work, you know what I mean? And she had to, and she, like, raised three boys and cooked and cleaned and ironed. There were no housekeepers and nothing like that. Is it maybe just time? And it's like, maybe you should just sit at home for a little while longer, go through that.
It's a personal choice. And I think if men... were looking after babies and had to breastfeed, the Parliament would stop.
Yeah.
The Parliament would stop.
I wouldn't go back to 2 years.
Let's hear from Ita.
I just wondered whether the Chief Whip made this ruling in the last few days when all the all the shenanigans were going on with the change of leadership, and he might have been distracted to give him the benefit of the doubt. You think, hello, this seems to be not a good time. He was probably not really thinking about what he was doing.
Well, the chief whip hasn't been in the job very long. No. Dom took over from Philip Ruddock quite recently, which is another famous incident that may or may not have been partly responsible for the events of this week. He didn't know the rules. There is actually a rule there that enables women to use a proxy vote in the chamber, so they don't have to express. They can sit there, watch it on TV. Mm-hmm. So it's all okay.
Let's look at some feedback, see what you guys think at home about this. We have this from Kai. In Canada and in European countries, they've let babies in so mothers could breastfeed. Why can't we? And this, another woman being told what she can and can't do. And finally, why can't she breastfeed and vote at the same time? Mothers are known for multitasking. Why is this different? If men don't want to see, shut your eyes.
They do say that a lot about leaders are blind, so I might not make any difference.